Many healthy people carry a bacteria called Staphylococcus aureus on their skin and in their noses. But sometimes this bacteria enters the bloodstream through cuts or other openings in the skin and can cause infection. Normally, this can be treated with medications. The problem is that there are strains of Staph aureus, referred to as methicillin-resistant Staphylococcus aureus, MRSA, that have become resistant to the very antibiotics used to treat them. These strains can cause serious illness, long hospital stays, and occur all over the world. Therefore, it's important that all healthcare professionals learn how to identify MRSA, understand how it's transmitted, and implement strategies to prevent transmission. First, it's important to note that there are two types of MRSA: healthcare-associated and community-acquired. MRSA is healthcare-associated when it's not present or incubating in a patient upon admission, or there is evidence that it was acquired during previous care in a healthcare environment. Healthcare-associated MRSA typically causes ventilator-associated pneumonia, bloodstream infections, or surgical site infections. MRSA is considered community-acquired if there is no evidence linking the infection to a healthcare setting. Community-acquired MRSA usually presents as skin or soft tissue infections. It sometimes appears as small sores that can be mistaken for spider bites and can develop into much more serious infections. Patients who carry either type of MRSA without actually being infected are considered colonized, meaning that the organism is present but not causing illness. Patients who have an MRSA infection show signs and symptoms of illness, including fever, increased white blood cell count, wound drainage, or change in character of respiratory secretions. In a healthcare facility, MRSA can be spread by direct contact with an infected or colonized individual through almost any care activity that involves touching the patient. MRSA can also be spread by indirect contact with contaminated objects in the patient care environment, such as bed rails, stethoscopes, patient charts, furniture, floors, even objects on food trays. Personal protective equipment such as gowns and gloves can also become contaminated with MRSA during patient care and should be removed prior to leaving the patient room. In order to reduce or eliminate MRSA transmission, all healthcare personnel must understand and follow recommended strategies. The first is rapidly identifying MRSA-colonized or infected individuals so that these patients can be placed under isolation precautions to minimize transmission. This is especially important in facilities that have high ongoing rates of MRSA or if there's an MRSA infection outbreak. To identify the presence of MRSA, samples should be taken from inside the nose and areas of skin breakdown. If the facility is intensifying its infection control efforts in order to reduce or control MRSA, the facility may also implement active screening to identify individuals who are at high risk of MRSA colonization. Your facility may define patients as high risk if they have an invasive device such as a catheter or endotracheal tube, a wound or break in the skin, recently received long-term antibiotic therapy, or recently been discharged or transferred from another healthcare institution, particularly a hospital, dialysis center, or long-term care facility. During outbreak situations, certain healthcare workers may also be considered at high risk of MRSA colonization, and nasal samples may be tested as part of an active screening program. Additionally, computer tracking can be used to identify a patient with previous MRSA infection or colonization as they re-enter the healthcare system. This can alert emergency departments, outpatient clinics, or diagnostic areas to handle the patient upon return according to facility policy. And be sure you understand and follow reporting requirements, both internal and external. Some states have mandatory reporting requirements, while others do not. However, facilities should always notify healthcare entities when transferring patients known or suspected to be colonized or infected with MRSA. This allows the receiving facility to activate its own MRSA policies.